Hello, my YouTubian friends. It's Monday, so let's not do anything too intense. How about we just go through five more Bitwig tips and tricks? Okay, here's one for you. You've gone, you've written your song, and this is the volume of each track that, and you want to keep it, but everything's too loud. So what do you do? Well, I mean, you can put everything in a group and just turn down the everything volume, but maybe you want that down with it all. Maybe you want all the groups down with it. Well, you could click the first one, hold shift, select them all, look at your info panel, grab the volume and turn them down. And look at that, it keeps the volume relative to one another. But as you notice, once it gets towards the bottom, it levels them all out until they're all off. And when it gets to the top, it levels them all off there too. Okay? All right. Maybe when you're done your track and you want to just see how all the automation reacts with each other, you could go in and you can go to each track and you can show the automation lanes and click for each one. Or you could just hold shift and click an automation lane and bada bing. Now every automation lane is open. So you can see how they interact with each other. Maybe this one's going up and down and you want this one to do the exact opposite. So you can see that and you can compare them all. And when you're done, you just hold shift again, click it, and it shuts them all down. Okay, here's a two for one deal. Say I'm gonna put a tool on my guitar track because that's what I wanna automate. Okay, I guess this is a three for one deal. One tip is to not automate this volume fader, because now once it's automated and you want to move it, it'll either turn off the volume automation or it'll rewrite the automation, and you might not want that. A better way to go is add a tool at the end of the track, click the amplitude and automate the amplitude, which is in effect your volume. Now, a good way to do that is, I guess you could press 3, right? Or you could go up here and choose pencil or pen tool, and it's the same effect there. But if you just want to make a quick automation change, instead of just touching the number 3, hold 3, make your change, okay? And let go of 3, and now you're back at the regular, the tool, whatever tool you were at just before, in this case, the pointer. Okay, now say I want that exact same automation on my other guitar track. Well, that's cool. Grab this, option, click, drag it onto there. Now it's on this track. Open it up, and look at that. It's copied it over. Which means when you copy an effect onto another track, it takes the automation with it. Okay, and that's the third trick of this trifecta of tricks, the three in one for you. Okay, so the first one is automate a tool's amplitude, not the channel volume. The second one is just hold 3 when you want to use the pencil tool so that you can return back to the pointer tool or whatever it was that you had before, and you don't have to click as many buttons. And the other thing is that when you bring this tool and copy it onto the next track, let me get rid of the first one, it takes the automation with it, which is pretty cool, right? Okay, here's another one for you. I don't know what number we're at this point. It must be 4, but one of them has 3 tips in it, whatever, who cares? Okay, so you've got this track soloed and you're listening to it, that's fine. And now you wanna listen to this one, but that one doesn't turn off. Well, I guess you can click it and do that, right? Or maybe you're listening to this track and you wanna switch over to the guitar, but then, you know, say you have this quite loud because you're really analyzing it, and you turn it off and now you're getting blasted full by all the tracks playing at once until you can come down here and click solo, and then you get some relief. Or when you turn it off, you hit space. That's all shit, okay? Don't do that. Hold shift, if this is the track you're listening to, okay? Hold shift, click the other track that you want to listen to, and it switches. It turns off the one you're listening to, turns on the other one, okay? Now, if you have a whole bunch of them turned on, like that, hold shift again, click it, click one of them, and they all turn off. See that? Say I have three solos, and say two of them are in a group like this, okay? And I have one soloed, and the group is closed, and I can't even see that it's a soloed. So now I might even go and unsolo these, boop, boop, doop, doop, right? Which is already a pain. And then now I'm still only hearing one track. Well, I got to find the group. Maybe you have a group in a group. You got to single it out and you got to click solo, right? The only alternative is, I guess you could press M and hit tab and you could hit the kill the solo. Maybe you don't want to do that because you don't want to be in that view. Well, instead of doing all that crap, when you had a bunch of them solo, just hit shift and click one of them and all of them turn off. See that? And now it's off. Okay, this is tip number 6,000. No exaggeration. Okay, so look, I'm inside my browser. I'm using my up and down arrows. That's fine because I'm all about the keyboard shortcuts. If the less I gotta touch my mouse, the better it is, okay? I got that Pro Tools mentality. So look, I'm using my up and down arrows and to choose whatever device in here. But say I wanna surf through my tracks, no problem. Hold down function and look at that. Now I'm surfing through my tracks. If you're on a Windows machine, it's page up and down. I don't ask me how I know that because I don't have Windows and I don't have a Windows keyboard, but it just, you know, I just know that, okay? All right, so when I let go of function, now I'm surfing through here. I hold function and I go through there. Now look what I've done. If I hold shift, if I press shift S, now I'm soloing that track, right? If I press shift R, I'm record enabling it. And now maybe I want to, I don't know, let's see. Maybe I want to add an Abbey Rhodes plate mono reverb to this track. And maybe I want it to be on that track. Okay, that's fine. Okay, now I've just added it. Oh, damn it. I shouldn't have chosen that one. Okay, I've just added it. And maybe I want to solo it and listen to what it sounds like. Shift S. And I want to record on it. Shift R. And that's fine. And now I want to actually record, command space, and then space, right? Okay, so now how did I do that? Because shift S and shift R are not mapped for you. Function up and down is mapped so that wherever you are, you can surf through your tracks. Well, let's press either command comma or click the settings and go into your settings. It might be here or something. Click shortcuts, okay? First, type in solo, okay? Toggle track solo, click here and press shift S. Okay, once you're done that, go here, type in arm. Toggle track arm, click there and type in shift R. And these are great because they're not assigned to anything yet. Okay, now go in here and type record, toggle record, click the plus button and hit command space. Okay, so now What you've done is you've made it so that without touching your mouse, you can choose a track you want to record on. You can solo it, record enable, command space, and record on it. And it's perfect, right? Because let's go over here, for example. Say I'm recording a guitar player. Well, I can press command space and then space. And now he's recording, blah, 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 blah. Oh, he made a mistake. Well, command Z, right? Undoes that track. Command space again, space, and he's recording again. And then, oh, screwed up. Command Z, command space, space, and you can record again. And you can do that over and over, and it's much, much quicker than stopping it, clicking anywhere, record enabling, or reaching over and hitting F9 the way it usually is, or having to like highlight it and undo it. It's all quick key commands, all centering around the space bar, and the command and the shift area. So with one hand, you can switch it. If you're the one playing guitar, you can just bring your picking hand over and kind of stop the recording, undo what you did, re-enable the recording, hit space, and start recording right away again before that idea is gone. Okay, is that enough tips? Do I have any more? Let me think here. All right, the last one's a little bit cheesy, but if you wanted to expand all the tracks here, and by expand, I mean like grab them so that you can really see them, just hold Alt, okay? Grab it and expand it, and now they're all that size. Okay, I know that's kind of a weak tip for you. Maybe I should have left that one out, but hey, some of you might not know it either, and it certainly helps me out because sometimes when I'm done my track and I just want to listen to it, I love expanding these out, right? And then I'll turn on this so that when it's playing, This thing is following the play line, and it's just a smooth, like, for example, see that? And now I'm running with it. It's like watching Super Mario or like Sonic or something like that happen. And you can just kind of sit back and listen to it. And by the way, if it's not doing that smooth thing, if it's going page by page, you can change that by going into your settings. And I think it is, let's see, what was it? How did I do that now? Here it is. User interfaces, view, playhead follow mode, continuous. Okay, it's just cooler. You can scroll by pages, but I chose continuous. It looks a little more like, I think Ableton is set up that way automatically. But anyway, in Bitwig, you get choices. Okay, I think that's it. Maybe next Monday we'll do another 5 more. Probably next Monday we'll do 5 more. Alrighty. Okay, kids, have a good week. Or unless I see you right after this video, which is super cool too. That probably means you've subscribed to my channel. And if that's the case, thank you.